Hi everyone, in this video I am going to explain you about anaphase and telophase of mitosis and cytokinesis under this cell furrow method and cell plate method. Anaphase. Centromere of each chromosome splits simultaneously, particularly lengthwise. The division of centromere occurs in anaphase. Sister chromatids separate from each other, and separated each chromatid is now referred to as individual chromosome. Number of chromosome become double in cell. As each chromosome moves away from the equatorial plate, the centromere of each chromosome is towards the pole and hence at the leading edge, with the arms the chromosome trailing behind. In anaphase, the major event is centromere splitting. Lengthwise, the chromosomal centromeres were splitted and forms daughter chromosomes. Due to this, sister chromatids separate from each other, and separated each chromatid is now referred to as individual chromosome or daughter chromosome. Each chromosome moves away from the equatorial plate. The centromere of each chromosome is towards the pole and hence at the leading edge, with the arms of chromosome trailing behind. The two new daughter chromosomes begin moving toward opposite ends of the cell as their kinetochore microtubule shorten due to depolymerization of tubulin protein towards kinetochoric end. After formation of daughter chromosomes, they begin moving toward opposite ends. Their kinetochore microtubule shorten due to depolymerization of tubulin protein towards kinetochoric end. Because these microtubules are attached at the centromere region, the centromeres are pulled ahead of the arms. The cell elongates as non-kinetochore microtubules lengthen. Anaphase stage is characterized by the following key points: centromere split and chromatid separation. Chromatids, now referred as new chromosomes, move to opposite poles. The main events occurred in anaphase are centromere splitting and chromatid separation. The separated chromatids considered as daughter chromosomes, which can move to opposite poles. Telophase, which is also called reverse prophase. At the beginning of the final stage of karyokinesis, which means telophase, the chromosomes that have reached their respective poles decondense and lost their individuality. The individual chromosomes can no longer be seen, and chromatin material tends to collect at each of the two poles. This is the stage which shows the following key events: chromosome clusters at opposite spindle poles and their identity is lost as discrete elements. Nuclear envelope develops around the chromosome clusters at each pole, forming two daughter nuclei: nucleolus, Golgi complex, and endoplasmic reticulum reformation occurred. The key events occurred in telophase are chromosome cluster at opposite spindle poles and their identity is lost as discrete elements. Nuclear envelope develops around the chromosome clusters. Nucleolus, Golgi complex, and endoplasmic reticulum reform. Let's see the diagrammatic representation of anaphase, telophase. See, in anaphase, centromere splits into two, then chromatids move towards opposite poles. Here each chromatid considered as a individual or daughter chromosome. After anaphase, in telophase, these chromosomes again decondensed into chromatin and forms nuclear envelope around them, and another cell organelles like nucleolus, endoplasmic reticulum, Golgi complex reform. Let's check this diagram carefully for your better understanding. Next topic, cytokinesis. Mitosis accomplishes not only the segregation of duplicated chromosome into daughter nuclei, which is called karyokinesis. But the cell itself is divided into two daughter cells by the separation of cytoplasm called cytokinesis, at the end of which cell division gets completed. After nucleus division, after karyokinesis, cell itself is divided into two daughter cells by separation of cytoplasm. This process is called cytokinesis, at the end of which cell division gets completed. In animal cells, cytokinesis occurs by constriction and furrow formation. Microtubules and microfilaments arrange on equator to form midbody, and at the periphery of the equator, a contractile ring is formed that is made up of actin and myosin protein. In animal cells, cytokinesis carried out by cell constriction or cell furrow method. Microtubules and microfilaments arrange on equator to form midbody, and at the periphery of the equator, a contractile ring is formed that is made up of the proteins called actin and myosin. Due to interaction between actin and myosin ring, thus a furrow forms from outside to the inside cell. Furrow deepens continuously, and ultimately a cell divides into two daughter cells. In animals, cytokinesis occurs in centripetal manner. Cytokinesis in plants takes place by cell plate formation, because constriction is not possible due to presence of a rigid cell wall. Many Golgi vesicles and spindle microtubules arrange themselves on equator to form phragmoplast. Cytokinesis in plants takes place by cell plate method, because they contains rigid cell wall. This cell plate formed by Golgi vesicles and spindle microtubules, which are arranged themselves on equator to form phragmoplast. Fragments of endoplasmic reticulum may also deposit in phragmoplast. Membrane of Golgi vesicles fuse to form a plate-like structure called cell plate. Golgi vesicle secretes calcium and magnesium pectate. Further, cell plate is modified into middle lamella. In plants, cytokinesis occurs in centrifugal order. Cell plate formation is from center to periphery. In some organisms, karyokinesis is not followed by cytokinesis, as a result of which multinucleate condition arises, leading to the formation of syncyte. Example, liquid endosperm in coconut. In cell plate method, Golgi vesicle secretes calcium pectate and magnesium pectate. Further, cell plate is modified into middle lamella. In plants, cytokinesis occurs in centrifugal manner. Cell plate formation is from center to periphery. In some organisms, karyokinesis is not followed by cytokinesis. Due to this, they forms multinucleated condition or syncytium condition. Example, liquid endosperm in coconut. Let's see the diagrammatic representation of cell furrow or cell groove or cell constriction method in animal cells. In this, small groove or furrow occurred in middle of the cell. Let's check this diagram carefully for your better understanding regarding cell furrow or cell constriction or cell groove method of cytokinesis in animal cells. Let's see the diagrammatic representation of cell plate method in plant cell. In this method, first Golgi complex, Golgi vesicles forms a wall-like structure which is called phragmoplast, and they releases calcium pectate and magnesium pectate, which forms cell plate. After this, cell plate may develop into middle lamella, then divides the cell into two. The cytokinesis occurred in cell furrow method in animal cells is centripetal manner. The cytokinesis occurred in plant cell. Cell plate method is centrifugal manner. Let's check this diagram carefully for better understanding on cell plate method of cytokinesis in plant cells. Significance of mitosis. Development of an organism occurs by mitosis. Every organism starts its life from a single cell called zygote. Repeated mitosis in zygote leads to formation of a whole body of an organism. Development of organism generally occurred by mitosis. Particularly, the single cell zygote undergoes repeated mitosis to form a whole body of an organism. The growth of multicellular organisms is due to mitosis. In multicellular organisms, growth done by mitosis. Cell growth results in distributing the ratio between the nucleus and the cytoplasm. It therefore becomes essential for the cell to divide to restore the nucleocytoplasmic ratio. A very significant contribution of mitosis is cell repair. Mitosis shows an important role in cell repair. The cells of the upper layer of epidermis, cells of the lining of the gut, the blood cells are being constantly replaced by mitotic divisions only. Mitotic divisions in the meristematic tissue. The apical and the lateral cambium result in a continuous growth of plants throughout their life. Mitotic divisions generally occur in meristematic tissues of the plant, particularly the apical meristem and lateral meristem, which results in a continuous growth of plants throughout their life. Up to here, we completed remaining steps of karyokinesis in mitosis like anaphase and telophase. We also completed cytokinesis of mitosis, significance of mitosis. In next video, I will explain you about meiosis. Thank you very much.